Okay, welcome guys. Yes, it's not Laura. It's the coach, Joshua here. This is Laura, as you know. It's been a minute, I think. When's the last time you've been on the YouTube?
Years.
It's been a
while. About 2 years.
She's still alive, all right? She's still a bodybuilder too. Quite wham now as well. Baby Laura is gone. This is what we like to discuss because it's been a while. But yeah, very cool day today. This is the second time I'm seeing you this year, which is actually twice more than I've seen her in the past 2 years. So, obviously, Laura's my online client and competitive athlete. It's been, in regards to the plans since 2022, we knew we needed to basically grow more into the bikini division. Yes, you can grow into the bikini division, as a lot of people think they're tiny, they're not. All right, a lot of the pros in most federations, they're literally mini bodybuilders, all right? The only difference is they're probably not as, no, not probably, they can't be as conditioned on stage as figure athletes, etc. But yeah, they're pretty wham. So we had to just basically grow into it. People may not know, but Laura is quite young as well. So she had to still grow into her body as well. So that was still happening. But we're here today, catching in a session. Long overdue. Mm-hmm. Next year, probably be back on stage. All right, she'll say more when she wants to. But yeah, this has always been the preparation. This is what we've been doing. I know she's ready. She's starting to believe in that, which is important too.
Surely.
But I know what the improvements we needed to do have happened. And yeah, no, I hope you guys enjoy this. I know for a fact that when it comes to training, Laura's actually one of the only few clients I have who actually does train similar to me. And that's probably because I've actually been there from the start with her training career as well. I've literally been able to mold her. So it's kind of like my wife likes to say, when she first met Laura and we had a training day with the team, she's like, yeah, Laura's kind of like a mini you in a weird way. That's the way she does things, even just the way she talks about bodybuilding, everything, training.
I mean, I've only learned it from
you. It literally has. I've been able to get in there from the start and I've been able to do that. Whereas most of my other athletes, like for example, our 40-year-old athletes, 30s, and all that kind of stuff, they've been training for years. So, and as I would always say, if you're a coach and you've got an athlete come to you and they've already built a decent enough physique, you're not trying to change too much, all right? I'm not going to try and impose my training style and everything on them. I'm just probably going to tweak a few things here and there, give advice where it's needed, but I'm not going to be trying to be that coach who feels like, just because I'm the coach, I need to teach them everything. Just scrap whatever they didn't know. No. They built a decent enough physique, hey, and they've been enjoying it as well, continue with that. But someone with Laura, like I said, it's a pleasure because like I've literally been there from the start, so you guys will probably notice we do things exactly the same. Might be some 2-3 minute sets, you know, rest between sets, we like that. So there, you're not gonna see us running around, we take our time. But also, yeah, we are old-fashioned, top set, backup sets, all that kind of stuff. But anyway, I'm rambling on, welcome to the channel, let's get going.
Yeah, let's go.
Your way, come on. There we go. Power up. There we go. Good. Good. That's it. Come on. There we go. Work for it, Laura. Work for it. Work for it. Good. All right.
Oh, sorry. Nice.
Good. There you go.
I just wasn't there in the end.
You're fatigued.
I was gonna, and then I came down as I was like, nah. Thank you.
you rinse yourself on that, you probably only get 10 on this.
Yeah. But this is like my, I typically range between 12 to 15 on my first set. Nearly drops my second set.
Yeah.
It's not ideal because you can't work with the load. Keep it within the 12-15 rep range.
Like I told you, don't worry. Now I know how heavy this is. I'm not expecting you to progress this. Like, it literally is for, so like for example, if you see in the mirror, you do your front pose in bikini. It's just helping with that whole outline of that. Yeah. That's what we've been trying to improve, basically.
Yeah.
There. We're trying to improve that outline there. And that's where, and then even for IFBB, when you do your front pose, which is technically a side pose, but again, just because that triangle, again, yeah. That's what we've been trying to work on. Because in 2022, you still look like you had no clap, like you looked like you were still no cap to the delt there, and you couldn't see that all the way across there. So that's why we brought this in, and it's working. So that's what I'm
I did get to a point where I was actually adding some loads to this.
This was peak your top body weight, I remember, yeah.
Yeah.
This was pre, this is pre when you went Bali and everything.
It was.
Was it just up when you come after that?
When was it? I think it was towards the end of last year.
Yeah. Pre-Thailand,
because you just went. Thailand, you got sick. Yeah. Injury, then.
Yeah, that was your peak training performance, I do remember.
Just before Christmas.
Yeah. It's all right, I want you to get your top set, don't worry. That's a 60.
Thank you.
You put it on that part or this one?
Yeah, on those two tops. Thank you so much.
It's all right, that's my top set.
that's how Jack gets out of it. He goes, well, if I pick your dumbbells up for you,
It counts, man. Don't think, just go. Just lift. Keep lifting. Keep going. And again. Yes. Come on. Yes, beautiful, beautiful. Nice. Somehow you did it.
I don't know how I did that.
You got out of it for a minute. Good. That's it. Good, Bernie's out, one more. Good, nice.
I do so much ab work in all my classes.
It's not needed anymore.
So, I mean, I do add it on every now and again if I have time or if I just have that extra energy. So I quite like doing the hanging leg raises.
Yeah.
Because that's what I used to do. A very similar movement to that on the floor.
Yeah, you're doing abs in every class.
Yeah. Pressure, I don't like the pressure.
Oh, I know you. You literally, it's because there's a camera here, that's why. switch off and go.
I can't, I physically cannot. Can I do two bros first?
Two bros.
I'm more confident with two bros.
There, and then you just need to do the prop, your lat, so put your lat into it a bit more, yeah. So instead of bringing up your shoulder, put your lat into it. That's it, there you go. That's it, that's what you want. That gives the cap as well.
It's about as wide as I was going before.
Yeah.
And then I just took it out a bit.
So yeah, you don't want to be too wide. That actually does work.
Well, I typically do go a bit narrow, but I want to, if it looks better wider, I want to start teaching my brain to go wider. Yeah.
Start with a wide, we'll see how it goes. It was, you almost forgot again, lat on that quarter.
Okay.
It's always the shoulder. So when you're facing this way, you almost forgot again. So obviously we're softening, but yeah. Because remember PCA as well, they really do want to see that.
Mm-hmm.
But everything else is there, that was perfect. I don't want you too much like that. This is fine. So good. Everything was good there. Nice to see more delts in you. Yeah, that's good. That's a good sign as well. You know how that is. If your long back is hurting, that's a good sign. Honestly, Laura, I don't know what we have to. Everything, we just keep the same. We don't need to do anything.
I feel like I need to go back to a posing coach.
You get better with the flow of things.
Yeah.
So it's like, for example, I don't have to call your quarter turns.
Uh-huh.
You just flow into it. That's in there.
Yeah.
And I know that's what you normally do as well. Even though you hear it and then you do it, you're still thinking, and next, and next. And you're basically choreographed.
Yeah.
So there, like your transitions and everything look so good because you are choreographed. Okay guys, so that is it. We trained, we did a lot of catching up, as we always do, me and Laura. I think it was one of the fun things about coaching Laura, because she really does want to learn. and she really does want to soak up everything bodybuilding. She will always be asking questions, trying to pick my brain, everything. And we also just like to catch up and talk. We do love bodybuilding and other things as well in life. Today's been really good. The posing afterwards, she does look amazing. I'm just reminding this so she can watch this back and again know that she does look amazing, even though she doesn't. But this is one of the many, many qualities of Laura. She is, it's very humble the way that she takes to everything she does, even though she probably could be a bit more cocky about it, but she doesn't. She just can't, and it's not bad. But then the great thing is, when she needs to, she does show the confidence we need. And that is why I am a very happy and blessed coach to be able to coach her. And I'm excited for next year. It is definitely happening. I'm putting it official.
Definitely.
No more guesswork, all right. 2025, the return, okay. And yeah, the silhouette queen, all right. I'm going to make this stick because she is the silhouette queen, okay. is going to be back on stage next year, and we are really looking forward to it. We've pretty much got a good skeleton idea of the game plan. The next thing now is just to really put it in stone. And well, the next thing is for her to go on holiday. You're off
tomorrow morning.
There's a go. So train, get a shoot in, go on holiday. That's it. That's a lifestyle.
Isn't good lifestyle
there?
To live.
That's it. There. Aside from that, training-wise, very happy. I was literally just saying to her, I don't think we need to do any tweaking, anything. Like, everything just stays the same. The only thing now is just literally tweaking the diets when we need to for whatever the goal is. Very simple, pre-prep diet's gonna happen, and then we have a break, and then we go straight to competition prep. But yeah, that is it. I'm gonna ramble on because I can do this, so I'm gonna stop. And this is thank you for watching, and yeah, tune in because I think she might do a few more videos in next year.
Who knows?
We'll see how it goes. But aside from that, I'm Joshua Conde, and Laura, because it is her channel, but she doesn't talk much.
No, I'll leave it down to you.
Take care, guys.